Maxforte.com. Hello everyone, ladies and gents, this is Max Forte again. I was inclined to do this video because for the first time I received a private blend or exclusive fake, and this was really, really disappointing to say the least, but very alarming and eye-opening. So I wanted to do this service to the fragrance community to be aware that, you know, not only designers will have fakes being produced. I think niche and the private blends will also start to have fakes as this market continues to grow and increase in sales. Obviously, the fake people out there will have their eyes and biting a little bit of the share of those markets. So here we have two fragrances from the private blend, the Armani Privé line, and one is a fake. I don't know if you can tell just by looking, but just by looking at the bottles I can tell. You know, okay, so the fake is on the left, okay? You can tell this bottle is a little slimmer. The real Armani Privé is a little wider, a little thicker. I don't know if you can see, but you know, the thinner one is a little bit higher. And then if you look at the bottle itself, there's a seam right there through the bottle, almost like this is how the bottle got put together. And the real Armani Privé should be smooth and seamless without any creases or you know, lists or marks showing that it was put together that way. If you look at the front of the logo here, the emblem, the real is flushed in the bottle, and it's a metal, not a rubbery sticker that you could just peel off and it will come right out. So this is definitely a fake. Another sign, if you look at the actual bottom of the bottle here, the real Armani sticker is of white writing, and the fake is like this golden writing. And also, if you look careful here, you should see some mistakes. You know, the actual sticker is off-center, the writing is off-center, the real one is like really beautiful centered. Not only on the bottle, it's on the bottom of the bottle itself, but the writing on the sticker is perfect, and this was off-center. And you also find some written mistakes here as well. This is Eau de Parfum Intense. And if you look here, the Armani Privé will have all the information here perfectly written, and this is just poorly put together. The bottles itself, if you put the bottles against the light, the real Armani Privé is supposed to be dark enough that light won't go through the bottle. And the reason why they do it that way is to protect the juice inside. And this one here, if you put against the light, you'll be able to see where the juice is on the bottle. And if you look carefully too, the bottle is beginning to stripe, it's beginning to shed, or you know, the poor paint job's starting to come off. And when you look at the real Armani Privé, it's a beautiful job. It's just seamless. There's not going to be anything coming off. It's just perfectly made. Another thing too, if you look at the caps on the bottle, this one is beautifully flushed in there. This one's a little higher, it won't go all the way in. And if you look at the cap, also inside of the cap, supposed to be black and not this cheap white. And also, as you see the line going through the cap, which is also a sign that it's a fake, this one is, there's no lines whatsoever, it's smooth and seamless. Again, look at the height. Look at the height of that sprayer, you know, and you could tell it's not all the way flushed in. This one's beautifully flushed in there, and you know, the perfect size. And the actual atomizer, the fake one, is white, and the Armani Privé should be black. So there's all these little, you know, signs that you could tell it's not a real. The box itself, this is very poorly made. This one is beautiful. The lettering is embossed there, and obviously the code here, okay, the code matches the code on the real bottle, okay? When you look at the fake, obviously, it's not going to match. You have a totally bogus number there, 38H71M, and this one's 38J21M, so they don't match. So there's all these little signs, so be careful, guys. You know, for these bottles, obviously, they cost a lot of money. You don't want to get burnt. And unfortunately, this here, this deal that I have here, that I've gotten this bottle from, this Oud Royale, was from a rather reputable person from one of the fragrance groups that I'm not going to, you know, give out the name, but I hope that that person will come through and let me know. You know, I'm disappointed, obviously, but I'm hoping that this person did not know that this was a fake. Hopefully we'll do the right thing and we can just move forward and move past this and continue on. But I'm extremely disappointed. I've never had, never had dealings with anyone with fakes. But and especially when it comes to like private blends, it's like, whoa, you know, what's going on? So this is just to create awareness, open your eyes, and be careful. Don't think that, you know, only designers are doing fakes. I think everyone, as long as things are being made, I think someone's out there doing fakes. So be careful, guys. Don't get burnt out. If you have any questions, please comment down below. Let me know. I'm happy to help. And thanks for watching, guys, and I'll have more for you soon. And also thanks to Al from Fragrance Fanatic 1. Everybody knows Al, who started doing this real versus fake. I'm not going to be doing this constantly. I just, you know, again, wanted to do this because I was really blown, you know, that I would have received a fake privé. So I really wanted to do this and let you guys know that there are fakes out there of Armani Privé to beware. But, you know, thank you, Al, for doing this. You've been doing, you know, a great job showing people what to look for to not be burned out with fakes. So, again, guys, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you all soon. If you have any questions, comments, please, you know, let me know down below, and I'll be sure to reply. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.